awake or do you want some more water?
You must be part of my hangover.
I can't hold any of you, but I want you to know my fondest hope is that one of you bumps the other off so I can pick up who's left.
And I hope the wax in your ears didn't stop you from hearing, pal.
I don't know who signed you aboard, Flynn, but if you ever try to get back again...
Me try to get back on this turtle, I'd rather have typhoid.
You've been a troublemaker the whole trip. Should have kept you in the brig.
I wouldn't have had to say so much of you.
Get this straight. I'm putting the word out about you. I'll remember your face.
I'll try to forget yours.
Hello, Bianco. You got a minute?
I wouldn't give you the skin off a grape.
I wouldn't give a nickel for your husband's chances before that parole board with all this going on. And I wouldn't give a nickel for your chances with those two apes running around looking for you. For you, I just wouldn't give a nickel.
For a nickel, I'd grab. Stick both thumbs right in his eyes. Hang on till he drops dead.
Knocking off cops is a tricky pastime.
They take a bullet just like anyone else.
Yeah, but more people seem to resent it.
Would you kill me, Rocky?
Wouldn't you?
I never count my chickens till I've wrung their necks.
Oh, Rocky, thanks for the dough, but you shouldn't have bothered. Castro's expecting you anyway.
That's all right, Russell. I got that 10 bucks from a typhoid carrier.
You believe in fairy stories, Ten?
Well, it depends on the fairy.
You and me are gonna have a small talk later on.
I'll be busy thinking of things to say.
I don't know why I stay in this dump.
Of course, you got a contract.
I'm not asking you to imagine anything. You're alive on a rain check.
Price is still 685 bucks.
How do you sleep at night, Fred?
Just fine, thanks.
Keep the change, Ted, and buy yourself some Lysol. Have this place disinfected.
You won't tell me anything about yourself.
Why should I talk about me when I got a pretty little thing like you around?
Are you in the rackets, Timmy?
Let's talk about world affairs.
You fellas gonna live here?
Maybe, if you're a good girl and go to church on Sundays.
Want a room?
No, I just came in to admire the decorations.
I'm very disappointed in Darlene. She turned out to be a part-time model and a full-time pickpocket.
Hey, I take my stuff upstairs.
This ain't the Waldorf, friend.
How long did you work here before you found that out?
Well, you two made up?
Darlene's gonna give up pickpocketing and start studying forgery.
Tim Flynn, you knew around here.
Brand new.
Where'd you come from?
I'm a socialite who'd like to try his hand at hard work.
Who got you the book?
The guy that told me to keep my mouth shut.
What do you mean, told you to keep your mouth shut?
That's what the man said.
What man?
That's what he told me to keep my mouth shut about.
I don't know how you pulled it, brother, but I don't want to see you back here tomorrow.
Better not look too hard, because here's where I'll be.
Maybe you need a little smartening up.
When I do, I'll get a smart boy to do it.
Come on, rip the other eye. Come on. Come on, rip the other eye. Come on, come on, come on. Tear it out of his head. Come on.
Let me get up.
I'll put this right through your skull if you get up before I tell you. What about the bartender?
I let him have it over the head with a peanut machine.
I'll get you up a dark alley one of these nights.
Run along, darling, before I fracture your spine.
You cheap little chiseler, get out of here!
Yeah, but I know where she's going.
What do you think we are? A two-bit stick-up mob? A breadline for every bum hoodlum in town?
Oh, you must be Castro's boss.
I'm Castro, and I don't have any boss.
Not even a wife, Mr. Castro?
I must be crazy. You're mean, you're cruel, you're cold-blooded.
I want you to give him your Deluxe Shore dinner.
But, Mr. Udo, the kitchen is closed.
Then open it, you squid.
Look, run back to your mix mastering. Cook up a few more of these.
Look, Mr. Malloy, I don't want any trouble in this camp.
Then don't start any.
Keep an eye on this. I'm going to have a drink.
Any more orders, Princess?
Yeah, my name is Tim Flynn. When the mayor comes with my key to the city, ask him to join me in the orchid room.
I'm what you might call a pretty big man.
Good, then you won't miss the money so much.
You know, big men don't scare easy.
And big men must get popped off pretty regularly.
I had a girl that once used to play the piano with her teeth.
With her teeth?
Yeah. Well, she had kind of long, brown teeth.
So what if a bookie gets hit hard?
Big joke. Big joke.
Never occurs to you that I got a wife and kids like other people. Well,
There goes the 2 weeks at camp I promised the kids this summer.
I may have a few things to say to a few people.
You better take your sorority sister home, boys. I think she's had a very hard day.
All right, there's 20. That's out of my own pocket. Remember, I got a wife and a couple of kids.
I haven't met anybody lately who hasn't.
Well, there's nothing the matter with Doris.
No, of course not. You'll have fun.
Oh, come on, Clancy. What difference does it make? You like Doris? And I think he's kind of cute.
Why can't he like Doris?
Why can't somebody?
Only the blind can really see.
Well, you're only half blind.
I'll fix that.
Yeah. I'm going in to get a drink. That should give you time enough to put back the stuff you probably stole from my room.
There was nothing there worth stealing.
Put it back anyway.
You drinking that stuff so early?
Listen, doll girl, when you drink as much as I do, you gotta start early.
Why should I knock off anything just because you're a policeman?
Thought you might want to try and bribe me. I'm always reading about cops being bribed.
I've got more influential friends than you in the Boy Scouts.
If you're trying to bribe me, that'll do it.
You wouldn't cross me, Pop.
I don't cross nobody.
I'd bounce you around like a basketball.
You don't want to stop, do you, stupid? I'm out one day and you try to fix it so I'm right back in again.
How big does the 50 grand look now?
Tell me all about yourself, Tim.
Oh, I come from an ordinary, everyday family. My mother was an oil heiress. My father was a Zeppelin pilot.
Did they ever marry?
Imagine me in on this cheap rap. Big man like me. Picked up just for shoving a guy's ears off his head. Traffic ticket stuff.
Do I see you later tonight?
No, Mary. As a matter of fact, maybe not for a couple of weeks.
Why?
Well, I have to go underground, you know, like gophers and communists.
You ain't carrying anything in your pocket, Tommy. You're dumb, but you're not that dumb. You'd get life if they found a gun on you.
Is the gun loaded?
You want to find out?
No, I'm happy at just guessing.
You ever hear of a game called Russian roulette? It's supposed to show how much nerve you have. Six chambers, one bullet.
You know, I got a hunch this is it.
Be careful.
Yeah, sure, I'll carry real bullets in my gun.
Keep this for me, will you, pal? You carry the money this time. We'll see if I can steal it from you.
Aren't you the comic and insulter?
Where are the car keys? If I'm not back by Tuesday, drag the river.
This is almost as nice as the ring you promised me when we were first engaged.
And remember, lady, that's not just a present. That means that 685 bucks of you belongs to me from here on in.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Fred told me he gave it to you for $300.
Mary, a successful marriage is based on a wife letting her husband lie a little. Now, let's not get started on the wrong foot. Don't worry.
I won't.
If you love me, you would.
You could turn off the shower?
I couldn't even turn it on.